Hello from the back parlour of the very historic Red Lion Inn here in Stockbridge, Massachusetts, nestled right in the heart of the Berkshires, absolutely beautiful part of the country. Today, I'd like to propose to you an arrangement of the ravishingly beautiful slow movement from Elgar's Cello Concerto. This was written in the summer of 1919 and was really the last major piece that he wrote. Alice, his beloved wife, died just a few months afterwards, and I often think this slow movement is like a kind of reminiscence, an elegy for his wife. And it's such a beautiful work, and I hope you'll enjoy it. I registered it at St. John the Divine using the solo strings stop, which I think produces a beautiful expressive sound. This work, apparently, when it was premiered, was not received very well, mainly due to the lack of rehearsal time with the London Symphony Orchestra. And wasn't played very much, actually, until the 1960s, when it was sort of taken on board 100% by the great cellist Jacqueline Dupré. And it's one of Elgar's most noble and wonderful pieces. I had the great honour to conduct this piece in the Three Choirs Festival in 2000 at Worcester. And it's a very challenging piece to conduct because every bar there's a change of tempo and all sorts of very intricate details. But anyway, here's the slow movement, starting off with a photograph of the Morven Hills, which really is the sort of, in a way, geological personification of Elgar's music. He adored these hills and was very inspired.